In this video, we want to demonstrate chart scaling and scrolling within Track and Trade. I'm doing this demonstration in the stocks version of Track and Trade, but these features are exactly the same whether using Track and Trade stocks, futures, or Forex. The first thing I want to make note of is that we are looking inside of the box that creates the drawing area for the chart, and this is how we want to control how the chart is displayed within this drawing area. The first thing I want to note is that we have borders, and you'll notice that the little gray lines up here at the top with an arrow indicate the upper border region, and that's controlled by hovering your mouse over the top of that arrow and dragging it up or down to increase that margin area above the chart. We also have one for the lower border, and you can drag that up, increasing the lower margin area of where the chart draws within that chart drawing square. We also have one that controls the right margin, which is down here in the date line. You'll notice this little arrow, and we can control where that chart draws a right margin as well. So by setting the margin, we can save those margin settings by saying apply settings to all charts or save settings as my defaults. We've now reset the margin areas for our chart. The next thing I want to talk about is the scrolling and the scaling. You'll notice that the price bar down the side has a split between it. It has a dashed line down through the center. If we hover our mouse to the left of the dashed line and hold down the left mouse button and slide it up and down, you'll notice that we are going to scroll the chart up and down within the window. If we hover the mouse on the right side of the center line, hold down the left mouse button, we're now going to scale the chart to a smaller size or a larger size within the window. We can also bring this back to center and back to within the scaling or automatic scaling by clicking this center chart button up here on the button bar, and this will bring it back within the borders that we've previously set. We can also turn this feature on and off through the right click menu by coming in here to auto scale chart. We currently have the auto scale chart turned on. If we come in and we manually scale or manually auto move the chart, and that will automatically turn off the auto scale feature. If we want to turn the auto scale feature on, we can either select it here in the right click menu, or once again we can click the center chart, which will also turn it back on. We also have the same feature down on the bottom window. You'll notice that we have the scrolling and the scaling not only for the up and down of the chart, we also have it for the right and left by doing the same thing on the date line. The upper region of the date line is the scrolling back and forth. If we go to the lower region of the date line, we then scale the chart in and out. If you would like to scale the chart in and out using the arrows on the side of each of the scroll and scale, that is an easy way of doing the same feature, scrolling the chart in and out as well. The last feature I want to show you is the proportional width feature within Track and Trade. Proportional width is what allows us to see a brighter or a wider tick style. So if we right click, we slide down to proportional width. You'll notice that it's currently turned on. If I unselect that, the price bars go a little bit less bright. They become a thinner single pixel price bar. And if we want to turn those back on, proportional width, it makes them a little bit brighter, a little bit easier to see. And that's just a quick summary of the scrolling and scaling and some of the chart features within Track and Trade.